kadachidhyayato sastru veda asam chaturmukat katam shrakshyami aham lokan samavetan yathapuraha. Once upon a time, when Brahma was thinking of how to create the world, as in the past millennium, the four Vedas, which contain all varieties of knowledge, became manifested from his four mouths. So in the chapter Creation of the Kumaras and Others, we are reading in this part of Bhagavatam how Brahma was also illusioned by the power of the Lord. And because he was situated, this verse also says, because he was situated firmly in devotional service, he, by the mercy of the Lord, with a little punishment, by the grace of the Lord, he did not lose the prestige as great Brahma. So if you recall last couple of verses, Prabhupada in the purport, he brings out some interesting thing. See, 30th verse, he says, O Father, this performance in which you have endeavoring to complicate yourself was never attempted by any other Brahma, nor by anyone else, nor by you in previous kalpas, nor will anyone dare to attempt it in the future. You are the supreme being in the universe. So how is that you want to have sex with your daughter and cannot control your desire? So we know there are many Brahmas, there are many Brahmandas, many universes. Brahma is a post. Just like we have a chief minister of a state, like that, a person who is elevated in his consciousness, he is promoted to the post of Brahma. So anybody can become Brahma by dint of his devotional service and austerities and knowledge and all these things. So here they are wondering how this, you are the supreme being in the universe, so how is that you want to have sex with your daughter and cannot control your desire? So if you see some pastime like this in the Bhagavatam, we come across, actually it teaches us how we have to be very careful and vigilant in our devotional service. So Brahma is so powerful, but he also, actually Brahma was thinking in the mind only, Prabhupada writes in one of these purports. That itself, actually, technically he fell down from his devotional standards, actually. There in the small purport, Prabhupada writes, the post of Brahma is the supermost post in the universe. And it appears that there are many Brahmas and many universes beside one in which we are situated. One who fills the post must be ideal in behavior, for Brahma sets the example for all living entities. So Brahma, we know in our sampradaya also, we are in, our sampradaya is called Brahma Madhava Gaudiya Sampradaya. So Krishna imparted knowledge to Lord Brahma. Brahma, then he instructed to Narada, then Vyasa, like that this parampara continuum. So these acharyas, they have to teach by their example, correct? So for Brahma, set the example for all living entities. Brahma, the living entity, is the most pious and spiritually elevated, is most pious because of his piety, he gets that exalted position and also spiritually elevated. He is entrusted with the post next to that of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Brahma is just next to Krishna. We know Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesha, these are all incarnation of Lord Vishnu for the purpose of conducting the affairs in the material world. So Brahma is the creator. That's why all the creation springs from Brahma. So this chapter also creation of Kumaras and others like that. And in the next verse also, Prabhupada writes some interesting thing. Even though you are the most powerful being, this act does not suit you because your character is followed by for spiritual improvement by people in general. Where Krishna says, whatever great man does, in the Bhagavad Gita, Yadad Acharati Shreshta Tatta Devataro Jana Sayat Pramana Kurute Lokatad Anuvartate. Whatever great man does, common man will follow. Whatever, so he has to set an example. In that purport also, Bhagavad Gita, Prabhupada writes, this is the definition of Acharya. Acharya means not just a title, he will teach by his own example. he will conduct his activity in devotional activity also. Just like if you see Prabhupada, he was a Mahabhagavat. He was not required to follow all these rules and regulation. But to teach people in general, Prabhupada also was, we know how Prabhupada used to write books from night at 12 o'clock to 5 o'clock, something like that, and attend Mangala Arati, chant, like this. Because he has to set an example. So that's what Krishna says. So Brahma is also in that position. So in the purport Prabhupada writes, it is said that the supremely powerful living entity can do anything and everything he likes, and such acts do not affect him in any way. It will not be affected in any way. For example, Prabhupada gives a beautiful example, actually. The sun. Sun is so powerful, correct? We all know in the night we have to put so many lights and tube light and this light and that light. And when sun rises in the eastern horizon in the morning, whole universe is illuminated. So sun is so powerful. And sun is so powerful, Prabhupada writes here, that even it can absorb anything, just a filthy place. It can absorb, but sun never get contaminated. That is the power of sun, sun god. For example, sun is the most powerful fiery planet in the universe. Can evaporate water from, see, just like rain is produced by evaporating water from the sea and all this process is there. Evaporate water from anywhere and still remain as powerful. The sun evaporates water from filthy places and yet is not infected with the quality of filth. Similarly, Brahma remains unimpeachable. You cannot find any fault, mistake in Lord Brahma, because such a powerful living entity next to Krishna in all condition. But still, since he is a spiritual master of all living entity, his behavior and character should be so ideal that people will follow such sublime behavior and derive the highest spiritual benefit. So this is the very important point. These acharyas in our parampara, they not only taught us the philosophy, that they were practicing also. That's why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also said, we have two aspects in devotional service. One is achar for ourselves, and then prachar, we should go and preach to others. So if our preaching has to be effective, we have to follow all these rules and regulations. Purity is the force. That's how Prabhupada brought out this. And in today's purport, the same idea is continued, and it is mentioned that once upon a time, because actually we know this Brahma of our universe, Prabhupada mentions also, is a pure devotee. Chaturmukhi Brahma is a pure devotee of the Lord. But many universe, we know in that pastime also, how once Brahma gets puffed up, because he thinks he is so powerful, he is a creator, everything springs from him, everything comes from him. So once he got puffed up, so he wanted to go and meet Krishna, Vishnu. So he goes there to the palace, and the doorkeeper, he asked him, which Brahma? He said, I am Brahma, just go and tell your boss, he'll know. So he goes and tells, doorkeeper goes and tells Brahma, Lord Vishnu, that Brahma has come. Generally we think, no, whatever little we are, everybody in this world, we are like that. We think we are the Lord, we are the master, we are the boss. Whatever little we have, we think we are great. So Brahma was also thinking like that. And the doorkeeper went and told, immediately Vishnu asked, go and ask him which Brahma has come. The moment this question was asked by Vishnu there, the doorkeeper duty came and asked, which Brahma? Then he said, you tell him I am Chaturmukhi Brahma. I am four-headed Brahma. So he goes and tells four-headed Brahma. Then actually Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna is so potent. He called all the Brahmas of different universe. Prabhupada mentioned in the lecture also, I think. 8-headed Brahma, 16-headed Brahma, 32, like that it goes on. Million-headed Brahma. They all come before Lord has called, they all come immediately and they take out their crown and pay obeisances. And in front of all these big, big Brahmas, he became a very chota Brahma actually, this four-headed Brahma. He was the smallest in the four Chaturmukhi Brahma. So you see, sometimes everybody is in come under the influence of illusion in this material world. Jai Prabhupada ki jai, Krishna Balaram ki jai, Nitai Gauranga ki. So this is, then Brahma realized, oh, that is, then he offered prayers and all these things, correct? So, so once upon a time when Brahma was thinking how to create the world, in the four Vedas which contain the variety of them became manifested. So in this purport also Prabhupada brings out the same fire analogy. As a fire can consume anything and everything without being contaminated, so by the grace of the Lord, the fire of Brahma's greatness consumed his desire for the sinful act with his daughter. So, fire is so powerful. So, it consumed because of his devotional service. The Vedas are the source of knowledge and they are first revealed to Brahma by the mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. While Brahma was thinking of recreating this material world, where it is mentioned, the Vedas are the source of knowledge. In Bhagavad Gita, in the 15th chapter, from the Vedas, actually we should come to conclusion that Krishna is the Supreme Personality. Vedecha sarve ameva vedyaha vedanta krit vedavid eva chaham cha aham. And thus, they are first revealed to Brahma by knowledge of Vedas were revealed to Brahma, where it is mentioned? In the Bhagavatam first verse itself, Tene Brahma Ridaye Adi Kavaye. Brahma is also called as Adi Kavaye, the first living entity. So this transcendental knowledge was imparted by Krishna to Brahma through the medium of heart. Tene Brahma, Brahma also refers to Vedas, Vedic knowledge. Brahma Ridaye, Ridaye means heart. So this knowledge was given to Brahma. Because we know, earlier we would have read also, when Brahma was first, he was the first living entity and he is supposed to be the creator. So moment he was born from the abdomen of Lord Vishnu, he didn't know what to do about. Everything is around dark, pitch dark. Correct? So Bhagavatam explained how he got a call from the sky that two words he came across. Ta and pa, tapa. So Lord Brahma underwent severe tapasya, austerity for thousands of years according to his calculation, and because of which actually Lord was pleased and he revealed this knowledge, the how to create and all this elaborately actually. So tapa, tapasya is very, very important. Brahma also demonstrated this. So in spiritual life, we all know tapasya is very important. Prabhupada says, I have given a simple tapasya. I have to chant 16 rounds, follow four regulative principles, and just go through this morning program. That itself is very difficult for us. Because if we are all conditioned soul. We have our own plan, our own agenda. But actually, when we have come in touch with this transcendental knowledge, actually, we should try to incorporate our life, even as a sadhaka, even as a devotee also. We should, Prabhupada uses the word, correct? We should mold our life in such a way, we should fashion our life in such a way, we go through all these things, what we have been told by the acharyas. Because these acharyas, they are like, Prabhupada uses the word, spiritual scientist. They are very expert. They have researched everything and they have given us everything. Just like today in modern science also, a lot of researchers are there. They are trying to find out the cause of all causes. But here we are readily available. What is it? Sarva karana karanam, Krishna says. Brahma himself says. Correct? Ishvara paramaha Krishna sachidananda vigraha. Anadir adir govinda. Sarva kara is the cause of all causes. How he causes everything to happen, actually. So, So we did that little tapasya we have to take. Rishabdev also say tapo divyam putraka ena sattvam shuddhaye desmad brahma saukyam tamanantam. When he's instructing his 100 sons, he's telling we have to take the tapasya, particularly in the human form of life. Naham deyo deya bhajan loke kashtan kaman arvitam vidbujami. Other sort of enjoyment, material sense enjoyment, it's available even in the life of stool-eating hog, that verse says. But when we come to this human form of life, we have to take that little tapasya. Those days, tapasya were very tough. During summer, we have to be in midst of a burning fire. When it is winter, we have to be in ice, we have to be in like ice-cold area. All these things we can't do. We are all very gullible in Kali Yuga. So for us, Prabhupada has given a simple tapasya this. So if we follow, actually we can see, we can also develop our consciousness. Then Prabhupada writes in this purport, so we know how Brahma lived for, Bhagavad Gita says, Brahma lived for hundreds of years according to his calculation. So his lifespan is so fantastic. Trillions of years according to our calculation. In that Sahasra Yugam Paryanta, Prabhupada actually brings out all the arithmetics also, how it translates. So when this happened in the previous kalpa, like previous verses also in the purport, Prabhupada writes, actually Brahma quit that body actually. He gave up that body and he got a new body here. Then Prabhupada writes, yeah, Brahma is powerful by dint of devotional service unto the Lord, and the Lord is always ready to forgive his devotee if by chance he falls down from the noble path of devotional service. So as we are all conditioned, we are all fallible. So by chance, if we fall down from the noble path of devotional service, Prabhupada writes here, actually, Krishna will forgive. And Prabhupada quotes this beautiful verse from the Bhagavatam. Any person who is engaged 100% in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. So we are all very fortunate. We have got this opportunity. We have no other business to think of, doing some business, earning money. Somehow we have come in touch. So we are trying to engage 100% in the transcendental loving service of the Lord. It's very dear to the personality of Godhead Hari. And the Lord being situated in the heart of the devotee excuses all kinds of sins committed by chance. So the sins we commit why we commit sin? Due to ignorance. Because we don't know, we commit sin. And people think that we can go on like this. But actually in the human form of life, we should know what is sinful activity, how this activity lead me to next life. Atahato brahmya jignasa, we have to inquire about all these things. We should not just live like cats and dogs, Prabhupada says, correct, in many places. So, if somebody is engaged in devotional service and by chance if he falls down also, actually Krishna will protect us. Krishna will save us. That's what happened to Lord Brahma also, because Brahma is a pure devotee of this. So these are the instances which show how when we come in touch with an opposite sex, we have to be very careful. There are so many instructions given. We know many examples in the scriptures. Prabhupada cites again and again about Vishwamitra Muni, Saubari Muni. They all achieved some almost perfection. They did tapasya for 50,000 of years. But still, they were allured by this sense gratification act. So, these examples are shown in the Vedic literature so that we should try to become very, very serious, sincere, vigilant, careful, like that many words Prabhupada used, where Krishna brings this point of the same thing. Almost same. How, see beautifully how Prabhupada writes purport. Here the translation is, any person who is engaged in 100% in the transcendental loving service of the Lord, And a lot of it is very dear to personality of Godhead Hari, and the Lord being situated in the heart of the devotee excuses all kinds of sins committed by chance. Where we come across in Bhagavad Gita, then very direct verse is there. Apiche sudaracharo bhajante man ananyabhak sadureva samantavya samyak vyavasthitaisa. Which chapter? Ninth chapter. See, in that purport also Prabhupada brings this Bhagavatam verse, actually what he quotes here in a trend, not directly but in the translation he write, the purport he is writing. So that Bhagavad Gita verse says, even if one commit the most abominable action, if he is engaged in devotional service, see, same like this. Any person who is engaged in 100%, is the year it is mentioned, if he is engaged in devotion, he is to be considered saintly because he is properly situated. Sadhur. Sadhu means saint, saintly person. Sadhur eva mantavya samyak vyavasthitaisa. In that purport also Prabhupada right, is mentioning about this Bhagavatam verse also in that purport. See, the mental contamination is so strong that even a yogi fully engaged in the service of the Lord sometimes becomes ensnared. But Krishna consciousness is so strong that such an occasional fall down is at once rectified. So Krishna consciousness, devotional service is very powerful because the most confidential knowledge there, Krishna is saying this. So even if we fall down by chance, so we should not take that... It should not be like a license, Prabhupada also says. You take a, whenever we are practicing, if we fall down also, we'll wake. Why we have to take all this gymnastic we have to do? We have to finish the Krishna consciousness business in this life only, Prabhupada says. Because Bhagavad Gita, there are assurance, if you practice Krishna consciousness, if you are conscious of Krishna, you'll again get an opportunity to continue your devotional service. Somebody may take little lightly, okay, anyway, I'm in the path, aram se karenge. No, we don't know. Sometimes we can be misguided. Suddenly, next life we'll get an opportunity, but again, there is a chance. So, then Prabhupada writes in that purport, and yeah, therefore the process of devotional service is always a success. No one should deride a devotee of some accidental fall down from the ideal path. For as it is explained in the next verse, such occasional fall down will be stopped in due course as soon as the devotee is completely situated in Krishna consciousness. So in this purport and next purport also Prabhupada brings out, therefore a person who is situated in Krishna consciousness and is engaged with determination in the process of chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, should be considered to be a in the transcendental position, even if by chance or accident he is found to have fallen. So we should, whatever it is, maybe little we fall down, we sometimes break some principle or something, we should, but only hope is we have to keep on chanting Hare Krishna actually. That's why sadhu means he is a devotee. Therefore, the sadhu reva is saintly, are very emphatic. They are warning for the non-devotee. Like that, Prabhupada goes on continuing this purport. One more example, analogy gives. The mark of a spot which may be seen on the moon does not become an impediment to the moonlight. Similarly, the accidental fall down of a devotee from the path of saintly character does not make him abominable. And in the next verse is said, Shipram Bhavati Dharmatma Shashvat Chanti Nigachati Kaunteya Pratijanehi Name Bhakta Pranashati. He quickly becomes righteous and attains lasting peace. O son of Kunti, declare it boldly that my devotee will never perish. So Krishna is again and again giving confidence, assurance, promising. Because why? Because we are all his son. Father is always concerned about his son. You know, son may sometime commit some mistake, accident he may commit. So he is assuring us, actually, this will be possible if we continue to practice devotional service. In this purport also Prabhupada is mentioning about Hare Krishna. But here there is no such condition, because the purifying process is already there in the heart of the devotee. Because we know the process. Only due to the force of Maya, time being, we may forget. Once actually, I think Tamal Krishna Goswami or somebody was asking Prabhupada in a conversation, it is there. Prabhupada, sometimes we are in Maya. Sometimes Maya attacks, exactly, I don't recall. So he was asking Prabhupada, we are practicing devotional service, we are doing chanting, all this. Sometimes we come under the influence of Maya. Actually, Prabhupada immediately corrected, not sometimes, conditioned soul like us, we are always in Maya only, actually. Because hardly we render devotional service, maybe chanting time or a few. But throughout the day, actually we should be conscious of Krishna. That is the secret. So see, Prabhupada has given instruction like this. Then Prabhupada says, because he is in the heart of the devotee, due to his remembering the Supreme Personality of Godhead, therefore the chanting of Hare Krishna Mantra should be continued without stopping. This will protect a devotee from all accidental fall down. He will thus remain perpetually free from all material contamination. So this is how it is. Because sometimes we are swayed away, due to the influence of some association, bad association, asa sangha, we may little be slacking in devotional service. Then somebody, Maya, will trick him. Oh, it's all rules and regulation here also I have to follow all these things. Better I may take up devotional service from home. This option always Maya gives, alternative she gives. Okay, if you are in the association of devotee, if you are in a temple atmosphere, lot of rules, regulation, attendance is there, this is there, you are asked why you didn't come, why you didn't do, like that. If I go out, same thing, all Prabhupada books are there, I can chant, I can read. Actually, it's very, very difficult, actually. We know in the association of devotee itself, we are struggling. You just imagine if you are out of the association of devotee, then we are to be in the association of non-devotee. There is only two options, actually. So we take all their influence upon us. That's why we have seen many devotees, somehow due to some weakness, whatever it is, after a lot of preaching by our senior devotee, they sometime sway away. They say, no, Prabhu, you see, I'll come for Mangala Arati, whatever it is, like that. 10 days, 15 days, they may come. 1 month they may come, Mangala Arati, whatever it is. And slowly, because the moment we are not under the protection of the four walls of ISKCON, actually we are all very well protected now. Otherwise, we cannot sit like this. The force of karma, very, very strong. Actually, we take it for granted. We should always think of this, contemplate on this. So, we are all fortunate by the mercy of Prabhupada. He has given us this opportunity. So, some difficulties, so some problems, some misunderstandings, all these things can come in the community of a devotee. But we should be grounded, whatever it is. I still remember one devotee, unfortunately, very early, maybe 95 or something, one devotee. Nightly we were doing devotional service. Somehow see, Maya will attack from different ways. Somebody could think, oh, my health is a big problem here. Some good thing, oh, health, I go to doctor, I spend a lot of money, Krishna's money, something like that, Maya will trick. Our duty is to only trick. So the devotee had some genuine health issue. So Prabhu said, no problem. What is the Madhu Pandit Prabhu used to say, no problem, what is there, you keep chanting and reading, yes, relax, you don't do any service also. But the devotee felt, no, It's a little embarrassing for me, whatever it is actually. He didn't reveal openly. Then he thought better maybe I'll quit and go. Like that he went. 95 and all nobody, we didn't have mobile and this thing. And like Sunday program we had here, those days also Sunday program was a big hit. Everybody is so busy, correct? Hardly we are 25, 30 devotees and so many things have to happen. Like that. So the devotee went on a particular Sunday evening actually. While going also some devotee saw he was carrying someone's small bag. Maybe something connected with Sunday program. Because now all the facilities are there. Earlier anything you want you have to go to outside, first block, this thing and buy in Bangalore also like that. So he went off and you know every after the Sunday program, Madhu Pandit Prabhu, Chanchalapati Prabhu, we all, they used to sit and how many people came, they, that, it was a big thing. 100 people came, 150 people, we are very thrilled actually in the early days. So like that. So suddenly we realized the devotee was not there. Then we figured out, where is he? And nobody could know where. Then anyway, he was a Telugu speaking boy and we had one very good devotee. He used to preach. He was also a devotee inside. So that devotee was sent. Maybe you go and try to bring him back. But how to bring him, where he has gone, nothing can be known actually. So somehow some intuition was there. Madhu Pandit Prabhu told you go maybe to Tirupati. Telugu people are attached to Govinda temple, Govinda correct, Srinivasa there. So he went, just imagine, he went to Tirupati and the devotee also found, in Tirupati like, yeah, can you find anybody if you are going with a group, if you lose somebody, it's going to be difficult. Today all this mobile and all that, those days very difficult. It so happened actually, the devotee, our devotee was sent and he met him there. Actually, he was preaching to him there also nicely, what is this? Then he was expressing, he said, no problem. We'll do one thing, we'll call from here Madhu Pandit Prabhu. So from the landline, he called. Actually, I was a pujari then, same Krishna Balram there. So I went to give garland after closing the altar, the standard thing. So that time this call came, it's very striking actually. So this devotee was telling, so Madhu Pandit Prabhu asked him, hey, what happened, why? No, Prabhu, I have this problem, health problem. Are you, who said no problem? Just be relaxed, come, don't do any service, just chant here. That's all. Who is forcing you? Then Prabhu was telling one thing which struck me actually. It all, I remember this always. Even if somebody throws me in a corner of the ISKCON temple or a boundary of ISKCON, within the walls, four walls of ISKCON, and even somebody spits on me. Actually, we should think it. Still, it is the safest place in the material world. Because the moment we are out of the protection of the ISKCON wall, what happened? Immediately, our all karmas take over actually. We can't peacefully be living. We may think Maya, this out strict. Like that, he was anyway, he took a call and he went out. Anyway, he's doing somewhere service and all still. That is apart. So this is the thing. So because it's like a dam, karma, effect of karma, karmic reaction, what is supposed to come to us. Like a dam, once it gets filled, actually there is a system where the water flow is sent to reservoir and all these things, and there is a force. So the moment they open that wall, water rushes. So like that, the karma immediately will take over actually. So somehow by our good fortune actually, Brahmanda Brahmite Kona Bhagyavanji Guru Krishna Prasade Bhai Bhakti Lata. Somehow we got the seed of devotional service, we have to take care, nurture very nicely, actually. The example in Prabhupada, in the purport here, the example shown by Brahma only suggests the power of material nature is so strong that it can act upon everyone, even Brahma. Brahma was saved by the mercy of the Lord with a little punishment. By the grace of the Lord, he did not lose his prestige as the great Brahma. So, the example shown by Brahma only suggests power of material nature, correct? Where Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, power of Maya, Daivi Esha Gunamai, Mama Maya Durattaya, Mam Evai Prapadyante, Maya Metantarante. In that purport also Prabhupada writes actually. Because this is the 7th chapter, Krishna was speaking about material nature and spiritual nature. Material nature is inferior and spiritual nature is superior, 4th and 5th verse. But still it says here, this divine energy is very difficult to overcome. But those who surrender unto me can easily cross beyond it. So that is the formula, that is Krishna is introducing the surrendering principle in the 14th verse onward. And again it says in the 19th and finally in the 18th chapter, Sarva Dharman. This divine energy of my Maya is this divine energy consisting of the three modes of material nature is difficult to overcome, but those who have surrendered unto me can easily cross beyond it. So Prabhupada in that purport, also nice purport, he says, Shiva, he's quoting from Shiva, only if you want liberation, only Vishnu can give liberation. Not even Brahma, not even Shiva. They are all powerful living entity. They are all as good as Vishnu only. Correct? But they are guna avatara. But still, actually, only Krishna or Vishnu can free us from the influence of Maya. So the principle is, but those who have surrendered unto me can easily cross beyond it. The Veda, in the purport Prabhupada quote 2-3 verses, the Veda confirm this as follow. Mayam tu prakritim vidya, mayinam tu maheshwaram. Although Maya illusion is false or temporary, the background of Maya is the supreme magician, the personality of Godhead, who is Maheshwara, the supreme controller. So Ishwara and Maheshwara. So this we should always remember, and we should not be overconfident in devotional service. I have rendered devotional service for 10 years, 20 years, 30 years. No, we have a very good example in our movement itself. People who are rendering wonderful service to Srila Prabhupada during his presence in this world, sometimes they also swayed away. So we should always remember, we should not be overconfident. We should not take it for granted that today I chanted, I have followed program and this, I have done my reading. All these things are good, required, essential for us. But still, always we should depend on the protection and mercy of the Lord. That is also the principle of Sharanagati which Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught us. So, a very good instruction to how to be vigilant in devotional service is brought out in this portion of Bhagavatam. Hare Krishna. Anybody has any question, any comment? Any question? Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki Tai Gaura Premam.